whole album that I've made is really inspired by the story of this amazing instrument. About 10 years ago, I went fiddle shopping, and I totally fell in love with this one. So I bought it, and I took it home. I looked inside this F-hole here, and on the inside it says Richard S. Howard, Leeds, number 6 violin, 1915. But as you can see, it looks really new, and obviously hasn't been around for, you know, 100 and a bit years. So with a bit of research from my dad, he found out that Richard Howard, in 1916, he joined the British Army, went over to Flanders, and unfortunately he was killed at the Battle of Messines, leaving behind all the carved pieces of this amazing instrument. But somehow, all the pieces, the unfinished pieces of this violin, made their way into the hands of a violin maker from Oxford, and he finished making it. And then I was the first person ever to play the finished instrument. I never planned to make a solo album. It was very much not something I was ever going to do. I play in other people's bands. That's kind of what I do, really. So it's been amazing to collaborate with these incredible musicians on something that's mine. I still can't quite believe this is my record. I'm still sort of riding that wave. The album's called The Unfinished Violin. I guess, you know, the simple reason is this was left unfinished, you know, in a workshop somewhere in Leeds. I guess that's the simple reason it's called The Unfinished Violin, but I like the idea that, you know, it's still not finished. I'm just the guardian of these bits of wood, and then when I'm finished with it, it'll go to someone else, and they'll keep playing it, and so on. But also, I think the other thing with this record is a lot of the tunes on it have been sort of claimed by the war. I really hope that people will love this album as an album and not just stick it on and think about the war. It's a standalone record that's based on that theme, but not solely for that purpose. I guess it's just a bunch of melodies that I absolutely loved, and I wanted to put them together. The fact that it's kind of related to the war is kind of happenstance, really. It's just a record of beautiful melodies, as far as I'm concerned. The album is an interesting mix of stuff. The British Army, they march to traditional English tunes, and I play traditional tunes for a living. So there was a huge amount of repertoire there to go with. I kind of wanted to try and represent, you know, not just English music, which is what I tend to do, I guess, for a living. And so, as I say, there's an Irish tune, there's some Scottish music, there's some English tunes. There's a couple of German tunes on there as well. It's difficult with a lot of the other European countries because they tend to march to opera, which is not, like, recreating bits of light opera is not really what I'm about. There's a couple of contemporary things as well written by Rob Harbron, who is on the album, featuring on the album quite heavily. Me and him wrote this piece of music called Rose Howard, and Rose was Richard's daughter. The number of ridiculous strokes of luck that it took to get to this point are just incredible. The fact I'd choose to go fiddle shopping on that day, the fact that that Roger had just finished it and put it in his shop, the fact that I chose this one, the fact that my dad found the stickers and did the research, the fact that I went on Radio 4 to talk about it and Ian Brown heard me talking about it and asked me to make a record, it's an extraordinary sort of string of events. So I just feel incredibly humbled and lucky to be a part of this instrument's, you know, journey.